All right, so today we will be working on lab number 8. It's the continuation of the previous labs, and in this lab we're going to learn how to create a game level. Typically, to create a game level, there are mainly two methods. One is called procedural method, and the second one is called the manual method. Procedural method is the one which which automatically creates the level using programming, artificial intelligence based programming. Since we are not get to that level yet, so we are not going to use the procedural one, but that's the one which typically being used in the game development. We're going to see the manual one where we can manually create the level, and we can repeat the level as many times as we want. So we're going to use the manual one. So let's see how we can create a game level using different the game obstacles, etc., etc., etc. So how we can do that? In order to create that, the first step is we'll get back to our the Unity game. So this is over previously where we left the lab number 7. So the first step is what we're gonna do is we are going to change the view. Firstly, I think we should use the abstract view. Well, let's create an empty object, and we can actually put all that stuff in that. So let's see what I'm gonna do is I am going to create. I'm going to place these red bars on the left side, because red are basically the cubes which we gotta collect. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to select all the red cubes here. So hold the control key and select the red cube, red cube. So I have selected the 4 red cubes. What I'm gonna do is I will do control D in order to duplicate them. So these have been duplicated, and then I'll go to move tool in order to move them. So let's select the move tool. Once you select the move tool, we can actually change their location. So let me just change them to on the y-axis side, or just put it down here. Okay, so let's slightly move in. All right, so now let me just select my let's say blue cubes. So I'm gonna select blue cubes. Blue cubes, and then control D, duplicate the blue cubes, and we're gonna do the same thing for the red. I think blue cube, did I miss any blue cube? Let's move them. Let's place it down here. Let's do one thing. Let's put it down here. All right, and let's select the green one. So let me select all these green. Control green cube, green cube, green cube, and let me just control D, and then move them slightly. So the green cube should be, let's put it them on the left side, these 4 green cubes. All right, so let's oops, sorry about that. So let me select these, let me just place them on the left side. I can see the blue one. Okay, so slightly move ahead and just place it down here. I guess still not. This is move ahead, and let me just place it back here. Still it is not All right, I think it's better. Now what I can do next is I can get some obstacles. Let's put this one here, big one, and put it down here. All right, and let's use the small obstacle here. Let's put it down here as well. All right. Now what I'm gonna do is I want to replicate this scene. So in order to replicate the scene, what I should do is, in order to replicate the scene, I am going to copy all these and put it in an empty object. So what I'm gonna do is, all right, so what I'm gonna do is I am going to copy all these obstacles. So let's create an empty object first. So firstly, what we're gonna do is we'll go to hierarchy window, create an empty object, and let's name it for example the obstacles, or let's say the level one, for example. So let's level one. So once we have a level one here, I'm gonna put all these stuff in the level one obstacle. Let's do one thing. Yeah, let's select all these. Right, so I have selected all these levels, so I'm gonna drag them and place them inside the level one. So I have created small level here. This is just a small level where all obstacles are right here. Now what I'm gonna do is I need to duplicate this level. So to duplicate that, what should we do? This is the level number one. We're gonna right click, copy, or the easiest way is Control D. You will have a new level one created here. What we can do for this is, if you slightly move it down here, so select the move tool. Once you select the move tool, you can of course make it let's see. Okay, so we can move it to the next and place it down here. All right, next, what should we do? We can repeat this again. This is level one. What we should do is Control D. Once we did that, you see another level is created. So we will move it next. So if you see, we got a new level created. All right. So now, next, for example, if you want to create more, so let's all right, I think it's good. Let's create one more and then it will be, all set. Of course, we will have all that. So let's create level number one, Control D. So once you have that, so we can move it to the left, so I can see that location here. All right, so now technically speaking, we have created all these levels. If you see, this is basically how it looks like. If I go to my game view, this is basically how it looks. Oh, a few of them are basically on the sky. So we gotta change their location. I think it's the level number two or level one, I guess. Level one, we should place them on the ground and place them down here. All right, so let's see the game view. Still, I think it is. And we should level number one. Level, this is the one. It's gone now. Slightly move it up. Yes, I think it's fine now. And let's see this game. I think it's fine now. This is basically how it's looking right now. And this is my player. If I go back,
Now my player, and I should move the player slightly, start from here, okay? And perfect. Now my go to camera, let's go to main camera, and let me just alright, so let's see, this is basically how that's the game scene. Let's slightly just like this, and let me just change the view. Alright, this is the view. I think that's the perfect view. Let me just go back to my camera again and align with view. Perfect. Now this is basically how it's looking like, and if I go to play, it still it is not good enough, so let me just change the view. So now to create building, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create put some cubes around, all around. So I will right click here and 3D object, let's get a cube. So let me just move this cube, and we're gonna move this cube, let's move it slightly here and move this cube all the way back and put it close to over the game object. So if you see, this is the cube right here. Perfect. I'm gonna copy this cube, Control D in order to make a duplicate, slightly move it right here, and let's place let's make another duplicate, and let's place it here, and let's do the same thing one more. And now what we're gonna do is place it slightly next right here. Let's make a set of this. Slightly make it close. And Control D again. And let's do one more. Control D here. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make all these cubes a set. And these cubes are the left side. So what I'm gonna do is, I think this is fine. And what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna copy all these cubes. And I am going to put all these cubes inside a variable. So what I'm gonna do is let's create a new empty variable, and let's name it buildings, for example. Let's name it buildings. All right, and now let me just put all these cubes inside the building. Let's slightly scale them first. Let's scale them. So let's use a scale tool. Let me select this cube first, and let's scale them. Building them. So firstly, let's change the location. Okay, and this one, slightly move it close here, click here. Make sure these buildings are close enough. Alright. Alright. Now what the next step is, we are going to scale them. So let's select this one, and let's select the scale tool and slightly scale it something like this. And this one, let's select this one. Let me just scale this as well. Right, let's select this, the third one. All right, so now Let me get to the other one. Okay, let's see how it looks like. No, these are too far, so we need to select them again, but let me just scale them all together and then I'll put it close to them. We can change the view as well, so that would be much easier for us. So let's go to isometric view and go to y-axis from the top. Okay. All right, so now what we're gonna do is, these are the buildings, so let me select all these cubes. And let's, and please make sure you have hold the control key once you select all these buildings or whatever. So what I'm gonna do is I'll slightly move them, use the move tool and move them all the way here. So place it like this. This is basically my player, so I'm gonna place it down here, these buildings, and let's do the same thing. I'm gonna copy this, like this is the building. So what I'm gonna do is, let me just put all these cubes inside the building, drag and drop, and then once you have that, so we can copy, we can duplicate the buildings. So click duplicate the building, move tool, let's see, move it slightly here and do the same thing, keep duplicating the buildings, and we have to place all these building all the way around and on the right side and on the left side as well. So I'm gonna pause the video so it's not gonna actually become too prolonged. I'm gonna pause the video and I'm gonna copy all these. So once you have all these buildings down here, the better way to get it done is, why don't we create another object here? Let's create an empty object and let's name it big buildings. Okay, and so we got a new object here, big buildings, and what I'm gonna do is I am going to select all these buildings here, select all of them, and then I'm going to move them right inside the building, like drag and drop inside it. So all these buildings got actually inside the big buildings. What I'm gonna do is now I can actually replicate the big building here. Let's say this is the big buildings, click here and D, control D. Once you do that, I can place these buildings on the right side and on the left side if you want. Okay, so I'm gonna select the big building, control D, and I can slightly move it here as well, and control D as well one more time, and I can move it on the right side as well. So we got plenty of buildings down here on the left and right side, and we can do the same thing here. Okay, so now big building two, I'm gonna control D and move them here, all the way here, slightly on the left side as well, and control D, and let's do control D on the right side as well, control D and left side as well. Now once you got it done, this is basically how your the game level should look like. Now let's see it, let's see how it looks like in the game view. Now if you guys see down here, this is the way how it looks it looks like where when we have putting the buildings on the left and right side. If your buildings are still slightly above the ground level, you just have to select that particular building and make sure you use a move tool and move them move them y-axis wise downwards. So this is basically how my environment now looks like. If you guys see down here, this is the way how it looks like, and I mean the look is something where I have buildings on the left side, right side, and all that things. Now what I'm gonna do is, next, if you see the sky, like this particular sky, if you want to use a solid color, we can use that. You can add some more buildings here on the left and right side as well.
use different scaling tool and please try to bring different ideas. For changing the sky color, if you click the main camera, in the main camera we need to see, if you see the clear box is sky, we can actually change it to solid color. And solid color, let's use any solid color, whatever you want. Let's say something like that, maybe. I think that's fine for me. Okay, I'm gonna keep this. All right, so once you have done that, enter now. Once you play the game, you guys can see here the solid color all around. And this is the way how game looks like. Just one more thing, which is basically, I just wanna add one more thing here just to show you guys. And to put a fog view. So what I'm gonna do is, for the fog view, you will go to window, and if you see the rendering option, there is the light setting option. So what we should do is, the light setting option, hold that and drag it all the way here. So window, rendering, light setting, and you can put the setting right here. I mean, append here if it is let you. So just append here, or you can do one thing. I mean, I'm just want to change the setting. So what I'm going to do is, I'll go to rest of the settings are fine. I just want to add some fog effect. So if you go to scroll down, apply the fog effect, you guys can see a little bit foggy, and the color of the fog, I'm going to pick the color. This is the color picker. I'm going to pick the color of, let's say maybe the green one, like this. Okay. And hit OK. Let's close this now. And now if we play the game, it should show you some fog effect. You guys can see the fog effect has been applied. It's just to add some kind of, you know, suspense here. All right, so this is basically all for today. Please, I really want everybody to make your surrounding more fancy, just put more buildings kind of stuff. And be creative rather than just copy pasting it. So try to bring some new ideas. So that's it for today. In the lab number 9, we're gonna create some more modules like timers, points. For example, once you collect a red cube, the points and the point system and the game end and things like that. So some more interfaces will be discussed in lab number 9. Thank you very much, everyone.